This is Samsung's side-by-side inverter refrigerator complete motherboard. This is its display control PCB. This one is the compressor drive PCB. The small circuit is used for the filtration purpose of this motherboard. Someone has already tried to repair it, but couldn't fix it. I will remove the circuit from its box and check what the other workshop repairman did with it and what needs to be done further. I have removed the compressor or IPM drive control board from the box. I have attached the neutral probe on the left and the line probe on the right pin. The pins left and the center are empty. I have taken electricity from its filtration circuit. The insulation of the wire from here was already removed. That is why I am using these same wires to pass electricity through this motherboard. Now I have attached the multimeter with the IPM board. Now I will pass electricity through it. I have turned on the electricity. The red light has started to blink. After a few seconds, the LED stopped blinking. The electricity is not passing through it. Only 6 volts are shown on the multimeter. I turned off the electricity, and now I will pass electricity again through the motherboard. It behaves differently every time I pass electricity through it. Now, 230 volts are shown on the multimeter. This means it is passing electricity. This LED light is blinking continuously. As it behaves differently whenever I pass electricity through it, which means that any component in the circuit board is short-circuited. Now I will start testing it. But before testing it, let me tell you what possible faults this IPM motherboard could have. Someone has already worked on this motherboard. The IPM has been desoldered and removed from this PCB. Other than this, these voltage regulator pins have been soldered. These are the two different voltage regulators. The work has also been done on some resistors and diodes. The capacitor has also been desoldered and then soldered back into the circuit. This means a lot of work has been done on this circuit board. Now I will start testing this IPM circuit. The first component I will check is the rectifier. If the rectifier goes bad, the fuse in this circuit will burn again and again. Other than this, it will trip the home electric breaker. The fuse is fine, and it is not tripping the electric safety breaker. This means this rectifier is fine. Next, I will check its IPM. After this, the turn wheel of the SMPS circuit. This control board won't work if the IPM is short-circuited. I will check the IPM. I have attached the black probes with the negative pins and the red probe with the positive pin of the IPM. No value is shown on this pin. That means it is fine. So it is showing a voltage drop of 0.594 volts. It should not show any reading on this polarity of the probes. The next pin shows 0.681 voltage drop, which should not be shown. Let's check the last pin. This pin is completely fine. Now let's check the pin by changing the polarity of the probes. Positive probes with the negative pin. The negative probe with the positive pins. See, it is showing 0.505 voltage drop, which is fine. The voltage drop on this pin is fine too. The next pin is also fine. The last pin multimeter reading is also fine. It showed a problem when I attached the same polarity of the multimeter probes. So I will check that too. I am thinking of passing electricity through the circuit. To check the voltages on these IPM pins. I have passed electricity through it. Let's check how many voltages we are getting on the IPM pins. 320 volts are flowing on the negative and positive pins of the IPM. Which are fine. Let's check the next pin. This pin should have 15 volts. But it is missing. Let's check the volts on the next pins. No volts on these pins either. The last pin also doesn't have 15 volts flowing. For reviving these 15 volts, I will check its SMPS. I already showed you that work has been done on its voltage regulators. So let's check it. Before testing the SMPS, I have desoldered and removed the IPM from the circuit. I will test it to see whether it is actually bad or not. Then I will move further. These three are the negative pins. These two are not connected. It is showing a voltage drop. This is the positive pin, which is fine. No value should be shown here. No value on this pin. This last pin should show a voltage drop. It is fine. Now I will check it with the next negative pins. This pin should not show value. This pin should show value. The next pin should also not show value. The last pin should show the voltage drop. Now with the last negative pin. This pin should show a voltage drop. Not on this pin, and also no voltage drop should be on this pin. This IPM is fine. Now I will check the SMPS of this circuit board. Let me show you what components I will check in the SMPS circuit. You can see a couple of voltage regulators and some capacitors. This is a 5 volt regulator. And the voltage regulator at the back side is 15 volts. We should get specific voltages on these capacitors. If these voltages do not flow, then I will decide where the issue is in this circuit, whether it is the chopper, the switching IC, or any other component. Now, I worked a little at the backside of this circuit board. The 15 volt voltage regulator pins were cracked. I think that is why the electricity was not passing through it. I have fixed them. Let's see whether it passes the voltages or not. I have passed electricity through the PCB board. As we know, 320 DC volts were flowing through the IPM's negative and positive pins. But I am checking it once again. 312 DC are flowing here, which is absolutely fine. Now I will check all these capacitors to see how many voltages are flowing through them. Let's check how many voltages are flowing here. The voltages are fluctuating here. Now let's check on this capacitor. The voltages fluctuate on this capacitor as well. Now I am checking the voltage on this capacitor. The voltages fluctuate on this capacitor too. This next capacitor also has fluctuation. This means this voltage regulator voltage will also fluctuate. This is a 15 volt regulator. As the input voltages will not flow, the output will not have any voltages. No voltages are on its regulator. The same situation is with this other regulator. I think this is why the LED light blinks. After checking all this, I have decided to desolder its chopper transformer. You can see I have removed the chopper from the board. These three are the high pins of the DC chopper. These 4 and 6 pins are the low side pins of the chopper. First, let's test the high pins of the chopper. These pins are 0.8 ohms. These high pins are fine. The pin between them is empty. Only the pins on the sides are joined together, and then the voltages are generated. The negative was installed. The pin I am pointing out had a negative attached to it, which was directly attached to the capacitor. So let's check it. 0.6 ohms reading is shown on the multimeter. All these pins have low ohm readings, but if they show values higher than 2.1 ohm or in kilo ohms, then the chopper transformer will be considered bad. The chopper has no cross connection or short circuit between these two different sets of pins. Now let's check the other low pins on the other side of the transformer chopper. Then two pins show a value between them, which means they are joined together. After this, the third and the fifth are joined together. These pins also show correct values. The fourth and sixth pins are also showing correct values between them. The transformer winding is not short-circuited with one another on checking it. This chopper is fine. So after checking all these components, I have come to a conclusion where that fault is. Let me explain you on the circuit board. I have removed the switching from this IPM board. I have found this rust beneath the switching IC. See, the IC itself has been rusted. This is possible the pin would be short-circuited due to this. This IC could be bad or fine. It could be known by soldering the IC back or installing a new one. The number of the IC is 2QR0680Z. The camera got a clear focus on this IC very difficulty. I cleaned this IC and the circuit, I installed it, and the fault was still the same. I will install another IC in this circuit. I could not find this number IC in the market, as I had only one piece of it. As this is not a common IC. Now I will find a replacement for it. Let me show you which IC I will install in it as a replacement. I will use this IC as a replacement. I have attached all these wires with this IC. So I could attach the IC in the circuit according to the same configuration as the old IC. While I was installing this IC, accidentally off the camera, a heavy object fell on the motherboard. The chopper also has been broken. The motherboard also has been cracked. This is a no repair motherboard now. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos and subscribe. Thank you.